What is a working landscape? Well, it's a healthy, natural ecosystem that thrives under human influence. Within a working landscape, you might find a farm, a state park, a business, a forest, and a home. You might see cattle grazing, tourists hiking, miners mining, farmers farming, and people working. Ideally, all the inhabitants within the working landscape will balance their own needs with the needs of the environment. Striking that delicate balance is referred to as mutual sustainability. Everyone's needs are met in a way that will maintain the landscape far into the future. To achieve this sustainability, three elements need to work together: the social element, the ecological element, and the economic element. But not all places can be working landscapes. Some places we want to protect or preserve so the natural state is maintained for the foreseeable future. In these places, ecological concerns are a much higher priority than economic or social. Other places have been so drastically altered through human actions that they can no longer sustain their once native inhabitants or landforms. In these places, our economic and social needs have taken priority over ecological needs. To have a successful working landscape, the social, ecological, and economic elements need to work together. Each element needs the appropriate attention to stay healthy and in balance with the other two. Obviously, humans are the source of the social and economic elements, and our actions have an impact on the ecological elements. But what exactly is the human role in a working landscape?
When I think of a working landscape, I think of a landscape where people understand how they fit on that landscape and are living in a way that works with the landscape. They're earning a living in a way that doesn't detrimentally impact the landscape. It's working with how all of the processes work on the land, and it's working in a fashion that it's sustainable.
So why are sustainability and responsibility so important? Two reasons: time and space. Most of the natural landscapes that surround us have existed for hundreds or thousands of years, and we want them to remain there hundreds of years from now. Our time as humans is relatively short, but with careful planning, time will roll on for our working landscapes. Space is another good reason to pay attention to working landscapes.
We know we're going to grow. Our populations grow, our economies grow. We get more buildings, we get more shopping opportunities. Where are the best places in the community for that?
If critical thought is not given to landscapes now, families, neighbors, and communities may not be able to maintain their landscapes for future generations. These landscapes will suffer under the pressing issues that face them. These threats may include poor farming practices, urban sprawl, fish kills, deforestation, loss of biodiversity, and coastal erosion. Of the many threats, three underlying issues are essential to the future of working landscapes: economic development, ownership responsibilities, and public versus private land ownership. There are many questions surrounding these issues. Can land and business coexist? Can cities grow responsibly without the detrimental effects of urban sprawl? What rights do landowners have? These questions are not simple, but if working landscapes are going to remain healthy for future generations, the answers must consider the social, ecological, and economic elements before time and space slip away.